how are you? And welcome along to Frank's Shed. Our guests today are the Crow Flies, with Mr. Evan Byrne.
How are you,
Adrian Thank Robinson. You. And Trevor Byrne. Good to have you here, lads.
Nice to be here, man.
I've been... Oh, hey! Yeah. Woo! Woo! I love it down the back. We've been following your cover band for years now, and so it's a pleasure to finally have you here doing your own stuff. We're so feel free to have a few drinks and wreck the place. Isn't that right, Joe?
That's it, man.
That's it, yeah. Joe's insured.
He's too late.
Right, so the first song you're going to play for us, give us a bit of a story behind that.
I'll tell you true, if I start telling you about stories and the songs, I'd probably be here all night. I'd rather let people just decide, or listen to them and decide what you think about it. You know, makes a song.
Make your own hypothesis. Yeah. What's it called, anyway?
It's time to be Rise, this one's called, yeah.
Nice one. Okay. Well, sure. Take it away. And right, the second song you're going to play for us is called
Hey, Where Are You Going?
Sounds optimistic.
That song was just about, I'll give you a quick explanation, that song was just about going out and going mental and forgetting to come home and telling yourself to go home or go home in a minute and just stay for longer and longer. The usual kind of story, you know? That's it. That's basically it.
Excellent. Well, sure. Take it away, lads. I'm gonna be so
fucking decode, yeah. And that's, if you listen to the words, you'll get your meaning, you'll know what it means.
There you are now.
Listen carefully to the words, poetry.
The challenge is on you. Do your worst.
Decode.
Decode. Well, let's hear decode. Cosmic closet for a good while now. So how long did it take until it became a serious thing?
Well,
jamming as friends and brothers.
It's still not serious, you know. It's we still have the crack,
yeah.
And we don't have big designs or anything like that. Just
And you keep it just
we want to write songs and just see what we can do. Yeah. And just we might release something like an EP or something maybe in the future or play a few gigs.
Excellent.
You know.
And can you tell us why you call it the Cosmic Closet?
Because it's actually in a parallel universe. And we go in this there every week about 7 o'clock. He comes out and like
he's in a different time machine.
Yeah, he's in a different parallel universe. We go in there anyway, and we play away, and we drink and smoke and
blues. And,
yeah, blues.
Bit of gone.
Big reggae.
And we come back out there after about 6 or 7 hours, and it's only 1 minute past 7.
I thought the clock would always read 4:20.
No, actually 8:47 because he's always late.
No fucking typical drummer, are you? Yeah?
He comes out with a wardrobe in the closet. He comes out of the wardrobe. That's his time machine. Doctor Who.
Typical drummers, like they're hired for their timekeeping, but they can't keep time.
They read music instead of clocks.
Yeah. No, but he's, as you said, he's a musician trapped in his body.
They're gonna eventually blow up.
So, can you tell us what got you all into music and what your influences? What did you all start out like? What was the big extraneous factor when you were young?
I had a metal band years ago, and that kind of got me more into music than any of the stuff I was listening to.
Yeah.
You were saying about taking it serious, we didn't really start taking it serious until we started doing all the stuff instead of covers. Yeah.
So if you had to describe the sort of music you're making, what would it be?
Makes a match.
there's
rock in it, there's bits of, I don't know, bits of funk, bits of everything, there's everything coming in, but we don't really have
a lot of punk and blues as well, blues like stirred in the pot, yeah. Funky blues stirred.
We listen to so much different stuff now.
It's actually a new style of music.
Yeah, Scottish music.
Yeah, shmusic.
Shmusic.
This time next year,
it'll shmoozy
this time next
long,
year, eh? We're going to be like... It's going to be like Michael Jackson.
It's going to be a dance called
Schmooch. It sounds fairly buttery.
This is hard smooching, man. This is hard smooching. That's what it is. It's hardcore. Underground smooching.
And have you any gigs coming up soon? Or what's next?
Yeah, we're going to play at Christmas.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, we haven't a gig organised yet. But I know a few lads.
We're just going to burst into Bernie Keegan and start playing.
We're going to try and play the Heyday
Festival, yeah. The right place to go, eh?
Currently, it's all booked up, but we want a few lads there and they won't turn up, so...
Everyone's only playing
for half an hour. Our members. Including none of our band members.
And when they don't turn up, we'll be there. And... so we'll have free drink for
kick some arse!
You know, free drink for the night.
Free drink or from
we'll play a few tunes and everyone tell us we're great. Oh, they're great tunes. And we'll be drinking all night.
Then the band split up.
We'll be loving ourselves.
Everybody here deal is probably.
We won't know where to move from there, though. You know.
And the name all collected is outside the Lenny's that night.
We live for the present. That's
president.
Francis
Higgins. We live for President Yoda.
Francis Higgins.
Michael D.
President I am.
And right, just for fun, fill in the blanks. I play music because
gets me high.
Love it.
What
do you mean?
Just play music because I love it.
You're a prick.
You know?
Fuck you, that's why. And I should support the local scene because
of likes of fucking shit factor and crap music out there, yeah. And get real bands out there.
If you had to change something about the music industry, it would be X Factor and all these reality shows that are cheap and everything. Yeah.
Manufactured music.
More access to radio and television for a few bands.
Yeah.
Boy, I love Johnny Robinson. Johnny Robinson.
it's not because he's your namesake, no?
Greatest talent I've seen in 20 years. And he just blew me away. And
can he sing in more than one key?
Johnny the Snake Robson.
I know. No, he's pure fucking talent, you know. And just because he was on X
coming
Factor,
out his finger
just because he was on X Factor, everyone laughs at him. But that, you know, it was just his own fault. People used him,
abused
him. Simon Cowell rode him up the arse for
that. Sounds like Simon Cowell, all right, yeah.
Simon's gone.
I hope you're good at editing.
I'm leaving that in it. You're all excited. He's actually going live now. It's another thing he was out doing.
No way.
I don't know if I can afford that many lawsuits.
I can tell you now, if you're Simon Cowell, deny these spurious allegations. And the last song you're going to play is?
Last song's The Watcher. That's just about somebody making a couple of mistakes and people just watching them and waiting for them to stumble and fall again and make the same mistake. And it was only a simple mistake to make, kind of thing like that.
They all seem so judgmental.
Somebody waiting all your life for waiting for you to fail.
Yeah.
Not that people looking waiting for you to fail.
Condescending.
That's what that song was kind of about.
Cool. Well, sure. Watch The Watcher.
We'll be right back.
Many drummers take a change of light bulb. No one having machines to do it now.
What's the fastest thing I'll learn? Stevie Wonder
speedboat. Why don't blame people go skydiving? Scares the shit out of the dog.
That's rough.
Great to have you aboard.
Brilliant to be here, man.
And fucking
thanks,
best,
man.
Best of luck to you in the future.
Cheers,
man. See you again
this time next year.
So this time next year we'll be millionaires.
All right, Ronnie.
Let's hope. We'll see you next time on Frank Shed. Thanks for watching.